cheesy grits. Want some, Vince? All right, my kid won't eat grits, but he loves the muffin. I love cheese grits, and another guy who does, Thomas Cawthorne. He's one of our viewers. 6 months ago, we asked our viewers, what's your guilty pleasure? And just like that, Mr. Cawthorne said, the crawfish cakes and cheese grits right here at the Big Bone, Wishbone on Washington. I could not agree more, Thomas. But I need some crawfish cakes, please. Make it snappy.
Does a pleasure get any more guilty than Southern food? It's all cooked in butter, glorious golden butter.
We're not a margarine kind of place.
Yeah, you go for it, man. It's your world, I'm just gonna eat some of it.
Enter the wishbone world of Joel Nixon.
Hey, let me have a bowl of cheese grits.
Bowl of cheese grits, please, one bowl of cheese grits. I know this, Joel, you can't have Southern food without grits.
No, you're right.
Don't poo-poo the grits. You gotta have the grits with butter and cheese, and you know, it's a nice accompaniment. What are we having those today?
No, I agree. Today we're gonna make shrimp and grits.
Yes.
And we're gonna do a crawfish cake also.
Guilty.
So let's start with dish number one. Shrimp, butter, mushrooms, scallions, fresh garlic, cream, and bacon. Jackpot.
Of course, we always get those losers that want it without bacon, but you know, we try to discourage them.
You know what would be awesome with this? A fork would be awesome with this.
In due time, I suppose, but I'm hungry now. So I just had to grab one of their famous corn muffins to hold me over.
That's perfect, right there.
Look at this. Oh, man.
Don't even have to put butter on those.
You don't even need to talk right now. You know why? Because you're a genius.
Seriously, this dude can do it all. From the shrimp and grits to the smothered pork chop or the blackened catfish with mac and cheese, and of course, the initial reason we came here.
My first time here was 15 years ago, and the first thing I ever had was the crawfish cake. It's sick, it's that good.
Joel starts with, now say it with me, butter. Then he adds fresh crawfish tail meat to the skillet, then some red and green peppers, scallions, garlic, a little cream, some breadcrumbs, and their signature cayenne vinegar paste. Puree it all together and mold it into a perfect seafood puck.
Okay, once again, he handed me a plate of scrumptious food with no fork.
Joel may be a tease, but his food is no joke, even though we are north of the Mason-Dixon line.
Is this just like the family makes on Sunday evening?
Pretty close.
Yeah?
Particularly when you eat like the collard greens or the blackened catfish, pretty close.
Blackened catfish is pretty damn popular, huh?
Very good.
Have you had the crawfish patties, crawfish cakes?
That's exactly what I ordered today.
Did you? Yeah. You know what? You're gonna love it.
They have the best blackened catfish. It's awesome. It's really good.
It's just off the hook. You were about to say that, weren't you?
Yes, I was.
She was. I'm hip. I know what the kids like to say. It's off the hook. How's that?
Yeah, that's
I'm totally worst. Street, man.
You're street?
Totally.
And real hungry.
Why is Wishbone the best?
We cook everything from scratch. We use only fresh ingredients. I don't buy any frozen anything. We have a great variety, we're a good value, and at the end of the day, we believe in butter and not margarine, you know?
Now that's what I'm talking about.
There we go.
I gotta give some props out there. Thomas Cawthorne, you said it well over 6 months ago, guilty pleasure is Wishbone. Can't go wrong, man.
We try to keep it real.
Yeah, real good.